this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you some cool stuff you can create with the Turbulent Displace effect. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel, and let's dive right in. The Turbulent Displace effect is one of my favorite effects because it is so versatile. It is similar to the Turbulent Noise effect. Instead of generating a noise texture, meaning black and white pixels, it generates a displacement map. I've already added a shape layer and a 4-color gradient. Let's add the Turbulent Displace effect, which you can find under Effect and Distort. Turbulent Displace. You can already see the distortion. Let's go over the settings. We increase the amount to around 350. Shrink the size to 50. You can offset the distortion map here. Let's increase the complexity to 10. And we get a lot more detail. You can animate the evolution here. In evolution options, you can create loops if you click cycle evolution. The displacement map looks exactly the same after 360 degrees or one revolution. It's always full revolutions. In cycle, you can change the amount of cycles it needs to loop. If you set it to 3, for example, it will take 3 cycles to loop. 3 is the same as 0. In random seed, you can change the animation pattern. I'll show you later how to use that. Pinning, you can choose which corners are pinned to the edges of the comp, so which corners are protected and undistorted if you want. Like the left and right edge only, for example. And here you can increase the render quality. At the top, you can change the displacement mode. And if you set it to vertical displacement, you get an effect like this. Let's turn it into an animated background and animate the evolution with a time expression. We add an expression to the evolution property and add time asterisk 100. The evolution value increases by 100 per second. Awesome. You could also use horizontal displacement, of course, or even cross displacement. And if we decrease the size, like to 5, let's increase the amount to 1000, and it looks like color pencil scribbles. And the cool thing is, you can add the effect again to add a second layer to the distortion, which is great to add more detail. Let's set the amount to 10, the size to 10. And I don't know if you can see the difference, but it adds this tiny bit of imperfection that makes it look more natural. Speaking of pencil strokes, the Turbulent Displace effect is awesome to create a scribble effect easily. I've added a shape layer again. No fill, but a 2-pixel wide stroke. Let's add the Turbulent Displace effect. We set the size to 10, the amount to 50. We duplicate it to add a second layer of distortion. Amount 5 this time, size 10. Then we set the complexity to 10. And the stroke looks like a hand-drawn line. To animate it, we animate the evolution properties of the two effects with a time expression. We add an expression, then add time asterisk 500. We add an expression to the second evolution property and add time asterisk 500 again. This creates a linear and continuous animation. Now we need to reduce the frame rate. Therefore, we add the post arrest time effect and set the frame rate to 8 frames per second. There's your scribbled line. If you want to reduce the frame rate only for the evolution property, you need to add the posterized time expression before the time expression. We add posterized time and 8 in parentheses. Add a semicolon at the end. The same for the other evolution property. We choose posterized time from the menu. Add 8 in parentheses, semicolon. Awesome. Let's duplicate the layer we can't see a difference because they both have the exact same random animation pattern. In evolution options, the random seed is set to 0 for all 4 evolution properties. If we turn it to 1 for one layer, the animation pattern of the layer changes. And the two lines behave differently. Instead of changing the seed number, let's add an expression to the property and type in the word index, which refers to the index number of the layer, which is 1. If you press E twice, you can see all the expressions. Let's do that for the other property as well. We add an expression and add index. The index number of shape layer 1 is 1, like the random seed numbers. Let's duplicate the layer. Press E twice to see all expressions. Index number 1 and seed number 1. Index number 2 and seed number 2. This ensures that in each layer, the evolution property has a different animation pattern. So simple expressions can just like that speed up your workflow a lot. You can create a particles rig, for example. Once set up, you can use it again and again, and possible with keyframes. Or create responsive animations that automatically adjust to your comp size. I know this is overwhelming at the beginning. That's why in my new course, we start from 0. In 30 lessons, we go through the basics. Basic expressions, responsive animations, dynamic text animations, and repetitive techniques. A more than 50-page long expression sheet will accompany you. Plus, I add new bonus content every month. You will create animations that wouldn't be possible without expressions. Learn how to animate with expressions in After Effects. Link is in the description. Finally, let's create something very different. A fire. We grab the pen tool and draw a triangle, sitting on the bottom edge. Let's use a gradient fill. The colors, let's start with red, the second color, yellow. We use the two handles to adjust the start and end. Red at the bottom, yellow towards the top. Then we add turbulent displace. Amount 75 this time. Size 100. And we pin the bottom. Then we animate the Y value of the offset property. We add an expression to it and define a variable for each dimension. Var X equals, we link to the X position value. Semicolon, we don't want to animate that. Var Y, we add time asterisk minus 600. Which decreases the value by 600 pixels per second. It moves down. Semicolon. We add an array, square brackets, x, y inside. And we created the main flame. Let's duplicate the layer and go into the path property and decrease the shape size. We move the three path points inwards. Let's change the gradient colors as well, make them brighter. And maybe change the random seed to 2. Instead, you could also add the index expression, of course. Let's increase the amount to 200 maybe. Alright, we're getting there. Finally, let's duplicate the shape one more time and move it to the bottom. We change the shape path once more and move the top point up towards the top edge. And slim the triangle. Then let's brighten the gradient colors once more to almost white. And maybe change the seed number once more. We should have used the index expression. and we created some smoke. You should add more shapes and fine-tune the settings. If you want to learn more about expressions, which you should, check out my course. Thanks for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. See you in the next one. Bye, everyone.